Hello and welcome to the Pool House Podcast. I am your host, Pool House. This day in time is a lovely day to review a wonderful book. And that book is called Scythe. A book about a world where there is no death, no war and no sickness. But people are appointed to kill those who have had their time. To kill those to control the population. And to find those whom are worthy of doing that job. Strange, right? Well, there are many important characters in this book. Such as a girl named Citra. And a boy named Rowan. Who were taken in by Scythe Faraday. To become scythes of their own. Other characters pop up as you begin getting further in the book. But no matter what, I think Faraday will always be my favorite. The relationships in this book are wondrous. Such as Citra and Rowan's relationship. They start out hating each other, then they don't. And they end up liking each other a lot. Well, how about that? The relationship between Scythe Faraday is strong with the two apprentices as well. He cares a lot for them, even when he does not show it very often. Other relationships with others are not too great. Especially when the character Godhard is introduced to the mix of the plot in the story. He's a rude little character who makes everyone feel awful. He is manipulative. Heh, it just grinds my gears. Well, the book is good. It shows a sad theme. That death is unavoidable even in a sickless world. No matter how many people are required to die, they refuse it even. Though in the age of mortality, it would come at the right time. Though it would bring sorrow to the characters to kill these people. They knew it was needed. Personally, I fell in love with this book as soon as I read the first chapter. The characters and the plot pull you in. It is very enjoyable and dramatic. I love it. The storyline holds so much more than what it shows. I know it could do better with some of the details it gave. I also wish it wouldn't have killed off someone I held dear to me. I wish I knew how it all went down though. I didn't get to finish the book in time before it disappeared into the Void's library system. But hopefully the Void will grant me with the book again someday. Oh no, look at the time. I must catch my train. I hope you enjoyed your stay in the Pool House Podcast. Goodbye, friends.